Growing up in Belfast as a teenager, for me personally, it was a pretty rough time. It was a very difficult place for me to grow up. I was very lucky because I went to an incredible school, St. Louise's Comprehensive College, and I found great escape and great solace and great fun in the drama group. You know, so whatever horrible things were happening, you know, in the city, in my environment, you know, I would wake up to some not so pleasant things, but then I'd be able to go to school and escape that and find a way to feel really protected, actually. And I had a really, really wonderful time in school. I loved school. It gave me great structure and it made me feel very safe. But apart from all the sort of the difficulties just being a teenager, you know, socially, on top of all of that, there was a lot of violence going on. So it was not the happiest of times. When I was growing up, you know, And still sometimes, believe it or not, I know I'm being very animated and funny with all of you, you know, but I think at the core, I would much prefer always to sit in the corner. I mean, this is a very difficult thing for me always to do, to be myself. So this interview is a very uncomfortable, difficult thing for me that I actually have to prepare for in order to be confident still, right? So if I was here acting a role and being somebody else, whether it's speaking in a different accent or wearing a different costume or whatever, I would not have a care in the world. Because also someone's giving me lines to say as well, so I'm being told what to say and then I make a choice how to play it. And I love that, you know, because then I feel like no one can really see me, you know. But I think that the, you know, I suppose the more one matures and gets older, the more confident I am. Yes, I do follow Northern Irish politics. I think it's very important to stay in touch with what's happening here because I do come back and I come back and meet beautiful people like yourselves. And, you know, Wimps is just a very important organization. And so I follow all of you and what you're doing. But, you know, a lot of the politicians come through New York and I'm often asked to meet up with them and to have conversations with them. And I'm certainly becoming more opinionated as I get older and more confident in being able to express my opinion. But I'm hopeful that, you know, people like yourselves will continue to make an influence, create an influence and perhaps encourage a change in what's happening in local government here. Although I live in New York and New York is an incredibly hospitable city and but there's something very special about this city. Like, today, for example, I was walking along the street. This happens to me almost every day. And people stop the car and go, "Hey, Jane, how are you? How's it going? How's America? Well done." You know, there's such a great sense of pride here and it makes me feel really lovely. So I think I'll take a little bit of that with me this time and hold it here for those dark days when they've said, "You did not get the job again." Aww. But I'll remember the taxi man today when I got in his car. "I am not taking your money. There's no way you are. We are so proud of you here in Belfast." And that, you know, that sense of pride that people have here, and it's just very, very, very special. I have never come home and never heard anything negative. It's a place where you really are encouraged. And if you really want to do something different and you want to go out there and try and make something of yourself in the world, when you come back here, they remind you how far you've come and they've got your back. And that's pretty special.